Dream for Chapters, a new adventure, and it's a following story from the long journey. And why did you decide to make this new game after such a long time?
Well, the last game in the saga, Dreamfall, ended on something of a cliffhanger, and people have been asking us since it came out in 2006. When the story would continue, and we said it will, but not when. So a couple of years back, we decided we'd had enough of working on huge, big AAA titles, and we started a new studio, Red Thread Games. We went on Kickstarter, got $1.5 million, and we started development on Dreamfall Chapters. So it's like a labor of love. It's something that we wanted to do since 2006.
We always intended to continue the story when we made the first game, and now we got the chance to do it. So we said,
"Here we are."
Here we are.
Adventures have a kind of boom in the last years, like with Walking Dead, for example, which is very successful. Was this also a reason to continue this game?
Yeah, I think the time is right now to do it. When The Longest Journey came out in 2000 in most of the world, adventures were pretty much dead. And when we made Dreamfall in 2006, it was sort of, adventures had been dormant for a long time. So we tried to do something there. It was a little bit different than The Longest Journey. I think in many ways people appreciated it, but it didn't really find the massive audience that we might have been hoping for. But I think things have changed now. People are more willing to dig into a good story. They're not too worried about having action gameplay or combat or stealth. You don't need that. You just need a good story, a good interface, and a way to just sit down and enjoy the world and enjoy the story. So I think the market and the world is ready for that.
And Dreamfall Chapters, what's story about in the third game?
The story continues from the previous game, and it concludes the story from the previous game. So it's and this entire series has always been about dreams, about stories. It's about where they come from and how they develop and how they evolve. That's important themes for us.
But also, this game is about choice and consequence. It's about how every choice you make in life has, you know, influences people, affects people, it has consequences, and that's a key mechanic in the game. You are constantly asked to make decisions, and those decisions shape your journey. And that's a mechanic, but it's also what our story is about. And you make decisions that you don't know what they're going to lead to. It might seem like a minor thing, but down the line, in later episodes, it gets to be a big thing. It can affect, you know, who lives and dies, who your allies and friends are, how the story sort of progresses. So that's a really, really important part of it.
You said it's episodes, so there are five episodes coming, the first and fall. Why did you decide to go for this kind of way to publish it?
I think, well, first of all, the game, when we first announced it back in 2007, it was an episodic. It was intended to be an episodic release, and the story has always been divided up into chapters, which hence the name Dreamfall Chapters. And then we saw that to polish smaller parts of the game at a time is much easier for a small team like ours. So it just made sense to focus on the parts that were already there and just focus on them and then release them as we finish them.
You can't buy one episode, you buy the whole game and you just get it as small pieces.
Yeah, I mean, we feel you only buy a season pass, correct. We feel that once you start playing this game, you will want to see it through. We sort of want people to make that commitment because it is, even though it's divided into episodes, it is one continuous story, and just playing one part of it, you're going to miss out on so much. So we really want people to do that and to commit themselves. So if people out there just want to play one episode, no, you can't do that. You need to play the whole thing.
In modern adventures, the interface is very important, and you're already releasing the game on console. How does it work together with to have a good interface and have it on both platforms?
The interface works very well on both PC and with the controller. It's context sensitive. You move around like you would easily with a controller and with a keyboard.
But we intentionally developed it from day one with both controller and keyboard in mind. And this is the kind of game that is, you know, enjoyed on the sofa together with other people. It's a living room game, so like being able to sit with a controller, even if you're playing it on PC, it feels right.
So you have to make choice and consequence together with the one you're playing with on the couch?
You can, definitely. And I think that's actually how a lot of people play these games. You know, there's one person holding the controller, but the second person is enjoying the story and interacting in a sense of sort of, no, don't do that, no, do that, make that choice. But the great thing is about the Dreamfall Chapters is if you're playing by yourself, you can still get that because we're creating a mechanic where you connect your game online if you want to do that, and you can see the choices made by others, and you can see which of your friends have chosen which option, so you can still have that social connected experience even if you're sitting by yourself, because we want this story to be a shared one that you feel you're part of a large group of people making these choices, going through the story, experiencing the journeys of these characters.
And this is also on console and PC?
That's correct, yeah.
Okay, and do you want to finish the story this time?
Yes, definitely. This game concludes the story, so we can steal. That was started in Dreamfall.
Yeah, but we still hope to possibly make another story in this universe, wrapping up everything. So you know, there will still be some things that are left unanswered, some mysteries left, because you need that. You need some mystery left.
Okay, so the longest journey didn't come to an end at the end. Coming to an end, but there's always something missing. Okay, thank you for the interview, and I'm looking forward to the game.
Thank you.
Good luck. May the balance be with you always.